Thrash, Heavy and Death, you might think, oh yes, the three dwarves they never mentioned.
Or your weekend, last weekend.
Okay, you'd be wrong. They are, of course, all types of metal.
Oh yes, and so for headbangers and other interested parties, here's Squeaky McLean at the Kerrang Music Awards last night.
Oh. I rock music, mid-period Genesis, when I'm feeling a bit dangerous, Chris Rea, and even a bit of Sting on his own without the guys from the police. But today I'm here at the Kerrang Awards, where the cream of the British rock guys are going to be here.
Best album is my controversial mate, Mr. Marilyn Manson.
You've just played Glasgow, Reading and all them lot. Who was the smelliest crowd?
Glasgow had worked up quite a smell, but I think I tend to be smellier than the audience, so I don't really wash my stage clothes very often.
Cut my life into pieces, this is my last resort!
Is it true, I read, that you were a champion clarinet player?
Yes.
Where did it all go wrong?
I'm a band geek.
As I say, I love the look.
Thanks.
What happened to you? You didn't...
See this thing, you go...
You've got to be careful when you do that.
Based on anyone in particular? Or...
Myself.
That is brilliant. Oh. How long did that take to do that?
I don't know, like a couple of minutes in the morning.
Not Star Trek.
Star Trek? Mm-hmm. No.
Ladies and gentlemen, give it up for the chairman of the board, Iggy Pop!
Listen, I love your seminal work. You did Snow Day with Chevy Chase.
Yeah,
you doing any more?
Beautiful. When the mood strikes me.
I've seen you in Snow White, Cinderella. I've never seen you at an award ceremony like this.
Oh, I gave an award last Kerrang Award. I gave one to Bush.
Lionel Blair's here. He's a British rock and roll star or heavy metal star. Will he be sacrificed by you guys today?
Never know. It depends. If he's cute enough, yeah.
Do you want to give a message to Lionel saying he could be sacrificed?
Linus?
No causing trouble, because I know what you're like once
Would
you start.
I do that?
Is it fair to say that you're like a little bit of a Chris Rea and Genesis?
No, I think it's probably more fair to say we're like a bit of a, you know...
Five mixed with Genesis?
I'd say maybe...
They're like, pretty rock and roll, aren't they?
I'd say Rachmaninoff mixed with Rage Against the Machine.
Right. If I was going to heavy metal, what makeup should I use?
What makeup should you use? Judging by your complexion, sort of a copper tone might work best for you.
You're not just saying, are you?
No.
You got your lip good. Did you copy Posh Spice or did she copy you?
Well, that's a stupid question, isn't it?
Well, that's the end of my report from the Kerrang Awards, and it seems now that I'm actually fitting in with my heavy metal friends.
Hey.
Yeah.
Real star Samantha Robson. She's quite sexy herself as well, Mike. But I thought you were flirting with me today. Anyway, here's Mike McLean.
Thank you very much indeed, the very sexy Richard Bacon. Morning Views are in Enfield this morning, where we are doing this.
Squeaky's all-new look-alike extravaganza.
I won't pretend if yours lookalikes are a ratings winner, and frankly, if I'm honest with you, well, we're jumping on the bandwagon. We're not just doing it for us, we're actually doing it for you, the ordinary people out there. As you can see, all this, look at the pictures here, lookalikes are big. We've got these two guys here, look like Helen and Paul, he looks more like Tarantino. We've also got the Harry Potter. As you can see, the guy on the left there is probably a bit fatter than the original. But anyway, what we're here this morning is because lookalikes are a big, big thing. Lookalikes are a big, big thing. And, well, you know, we've got loads of things happening, which means ordinary people here in Enfield Market may be walking around unaware that they do look like a famous person, and they're missing out on the opportunity of making lots and lots of money. With me is Clark Gable. He's not really, it's Gene Dable. Morning, Gene.
Morning.
He's the managing director of Top Lookalike Agency. He represents some of the best lookalikes in the business, and he will be helping us find some lookalikes a little bit later on in the show. But let's cut to the chase. How much can a lookalike earn?
Yeah, it starts at about £300 an hour, Mike.
£300 an hour. That is a lot. Now, although we want to find as many lookalikes as possible, we obviously have a hit list of people that we really, really want. We've got a board here, okay, and we've done our research, and we rang around almost as many lookalikes agency in the country as possible, and these are some of the stars that we found that didn't have doubles, okay? That's Neil and Christine Hamilton. These, again, the stars that didn't have doubles, okay? We've got Ian Duncan Smith. We've got Hugh Edwards, he's the guy that reads the news. Tom Selleck, now he did have a lookalike, but unfortunately there wasn't much work for him. Mike McLean, I definitely don't have a lookalike, although I've been told I do look like Alan Partridge. And also that bird from Big Brother, Penny. Well, join us a little bit later on. We'll be scouring the market to find some lookalikes with him, Clark Gable, and me, Mike McLean. But for now, it's back to the house.
Oh, thank you very much. Jasmine, no time to chat to you now. But instead, I don't know if you've read about this in the papers today already, but David Blaine, the popular magician, he do you know he featured on, he was interviewed on GMTV yesterday.
GM1.
Now, yeah, more fool him.
Yeah.
Now, normally, obviously, normally we wouldn't plug that, but today we make an exception, because things didn't really go very well. And we've actually nicked this clip from GMTV, and here is David chatting to one Eamon Holmes.
Turn to page 30, and you're going to feel something and see something happen.
Oh, my God.
Hey, how does he do that? I'm sure you're not going to tell me. Indeed. Yes, that's what I assumed. Of course, you're famous in this country as well for appearing in a car advert. Doing tricks as well. Card tricks. Excellent. Is it a trick to talk? Is it? No. What is your next trick going to be? The stare and the eyes and all that sort of thing? That's just you. That's just you. The eye and the hand. And what is that? What is the eye and the hand? Let's see that again.
Protection.
Protection. What does that mean?
Protection from death.
Oh. That's what I'd say. Nice meeting you.
Okay.
Bye bye. Different.
Bye. Very different. Shall we take a break now? I think maybe we should.
Look at the shock on Emma Bunton's face.
Shocked.
Well, I mean, you know, I don't know what happened there.
It's outrageous, isn't it?
I think because you know David Blaine came on this show a few months ago and he loved us. He had a great time.
Was he did. Right?
He did magic. We did OB with him as well. I think
he wasn't weird at all.
So much so he stuck around for ages after the show. So I don't know what happened. I think he perhaps took an instant dislike to Eamon.
Oh, I love Eamon. Lovely.
But
yeah.
That can't be true.
It can't.
You know,
be
many
true.
Ways I feel sorry for Eamon on this occasion. He says no. It's in the end. Mike McLean!
Thank you very much today, Richard. We're live in Enfield this morning. We're on the Oil B. We're doing this.
Squeaky's all-new look-alike extravaganza.
Yeah, it seems to me now that it's becoming easier and easier for anybody to be a lookalike. They can make their living as a lookalike these days. In fact, anybody can do it. With me is Gene from one of the top London lookalike agencies. He's also a lookalike Clark Gable as well. What we're going to do this morning is find some people and change their lives because they don't know yet. Let's walk and talk. That they could be looking like somebody famous and they could earn. Look at him, Marilyn Manson. Don't say him, but he looks like Marilyn Manson, doesn't he?
All he needs is one of those rabbits.
That's right, yeah. And they can earn good money, can't they?
Yeah, about £300 an hour to start out with.
He looks like somebody. Boy, has anyone ever told you you look like somebody famous?
No.
Who do you think you look like? Have a look in the mirror. Have a look in the mirror there. Who do you think you look like?
Oh, God. Who do I look like?
Yeah, probably
my uncle, maybe.
You probably do look like your uncle. Let's have a look. Let's go down here, because man
sort of
on a scooter.
Green version of Vinnie Jones.
He is, isn't he? Look right down here, because come over here. Come on over. Bring it on. You look at this. You'll absolutely love this. Look at him. We've got two people that probably look like something. Good morning.
Good morning.
Has anyone ever told you you look like somebody famous?
Not recently.
Okay.
That's surprise there.
Has anyone ever told you you look like somebody famous?
Never.
Who do you reckon he looks like?
Robert Redford.
No, Robert Redford. Them glasses aren't working. Who do you reckon he looks like?
Fred Flintstone.
He could look like Fred Flintstone.
Oh, no, the guy off the Royals. That's what it
Jim
is.
Yeah, the guy off Jim Royals.
That's right, Jim Royals.
But do you know who you look like? If you don't mind me saying so, you probably look like Walter Matthau.
Walter Matthau.
Yeah, doesn't he look like Walter Matthau? Yeah. Doesn't he look like Walter Matthau?
You do that accent.
Doesn't he look like Walter Matthau? Okay.
All we need is a gentleman. We got the odd couple,
we
are, right?
We want you to be in our parade later on. Both of you being our lookalike parade. Could change your lives forever. Would you take part in that?
Yeah, of course.
Excellent. Thank you very much indeed. Who does he look like? Rod Stewart. That's definitely Rod Stewart.
Rod Stewart's boy.
You do.
Clark Kent.
Oh, Clark.
Come on, let's go, because we've got down here. Come on over here, because... Well, I don't believe it. Look, 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 just come out, just come out. Look, look, look. Has anyone ever told you look like somebody famous?
Yeah.
Come in. Rod, come in.
Jack Nicholson.
Jack Nicholson, is that right? Listen, will you take part in our parade later on?
Yeah, sure.
Excellent.
Yeah, lovely.
Oh, brilliant. Come on, let's go. Come on, we've only got 45 seconds. Let's go down here somewhere else. Look at that, we've got Ian. Oh, look, look, come on, quickly. Morning. How are you doing, B-Man? You all right?
Thank you.
Come over here. Has anyone ever told you look like somebody famous?
Who?
Mike? Okay.
No, they haven't.
Who? Okay. Look over here. Just come here. Look, we got. Come over here. Peggy Mitchell. It's definitely Peggy Mitchell. Look. We've got Ian Duncan Smith and William A. Put your heads together. Looks like. Put your heads right down. Looks like a bottom. Excellent. Well, listen, want you to take part. Will you take part in our parade later on?
Yeah, sure.
Okay, excellent. And obviously, the guy that you saw on GMTV yesterday chatting to Eamon Holmes, he's got a bit more live today. David Blaine's here as well. He's going to make this spot. Anybody, David Blaine? Listen, will you come in our parade later on, David? We don't want you to levitate or anything like that. We just want you to be in our parade, yeah?
All right, mate.
Okay, join us a little bit later on. We've got celebrity guests to judge it. You're going to be judging our look
like. That's
and isn't that right? The winner could go on your books to make a lot of money.
That's right. Oh, sure.
Okay.
Never know when you're going to get a call for Ian Duncan Smith over there.
Okay, well, David, join us a little bit later on. We'll have a great parade here live at Enfield Market. But right now, it's back to the house. Do I look like anything?
Mike, ask David Blaine if he finds Eamon Holmes soporific.
Oh.
Oh, is he gone? Have we lost it? Okay, got him.
David Blaine.
Can't get him.
Does he find Eamon Holmes soporific?
Yesterday, you were chatting to Eamon Holmes on GMTV. Is he boring?
Yeah.
Is that why you didn't say much?
Yeah.
Could you show us your hand? Where's the eye?
Oh, yeah.
It's gone. Are you a better magician than me? Jack Nicholson!
There's no shortage of look.
Could you, Mr. Jack?
Oh, this is
Could you make Jack Nicholson disappear?
Yeah.
Yes!
This is great. Why don't you encase that man in a block of ice? Mike, thank you. More from you later. We'll have more of that later.
This is top TV.
I think they should play Eamon Holmes' interviews in flotation tanks instead of wind chimes and things.
Now, I'll like remind Eamon you. Really.
Welcome back. Yes. Now, you don't have to be a gifted instrumentalist for millions to enjoy your music. Take the likes of Robbie Williams, Eminem, or even Slipknot. Our next guest has joined this exclusive clan. Please welcome Zach Munro. Oh! Who is... You're simply the best. Zach Munro!
I'm so sorry.
All right, mate, have a seat. Welcome to the show.
Thank you very much indeed, Richard Bacon. We're coming to you live from Enfield Market for the final of this.
Squeaky's all-new look-alike extravaganza.
As you know, anybody can make a living as a look-alike these days. We've come to a down market in Enfield for a down market look-alike final. Earlier on, we gathered some people who were unaware that they looked like somebody famous. Until now. Let's meet the judges. We've got Penny from Big Brother. Morning, Penny.
Hi.
How are you?
Very well, thank you.
Excellent. We've got Jean as well, who you've seen before, Clark Gale. Morning, Jean.
Morning again, Mike.
And we've also got the mayor of Enfield. You're not a lookalike, you are the real mayor.
That's right, that's me.
Thank you very much indeed. Well, without further ado, let's get this underway. Here we go with lookalike number one, everybody. On you come, lookalike number one. He's Barry's got a fancy good stuff, and he looks like Terry Thomas. Say your line. Yes, Terry Thomas, everybody. Here we go. Just stand there, please, Barry. Here we go. And we've got Larkin. He's a brick and brack holder. He looks like Leslie Nielsen.
Call me Shirley.
Say it again.
Don't call me Shirley.
Thank you very much indeed. Stand there. We've got Derek and Barry. They run a haberdashery, and they look like Ian Duncan Smith. Say it again.
Vote for us.
Ian Duncan Smith. Well done. Stand over there. Excellent. I don't know which one was the doll. Right, we've got Judith. She's exclusive, ladies, and she looks like Denise Wells.
Orders.
No, you got to say it again. Wait till I said it. I said, she looks like Denise Wells from Coronation Street. What did you say?
Last order.
Right, get off. Well done indeed. We've got Alan, he's a customer. He looks like Shane from Westlife.
I'm flying without wings.
You certainly are. Clear off. Right, here we go. Well done indeed. We've got Ian, he's from Cosmetics, and he looks like Morton from Aha.
The sun always shines on TV.
Yeah, round of applause. Hold on one second. Right, here we go. Next one is we've got Andy, he's close. He looks like Mick Jagger.
And I can't get no satisfaction.
You can't. Well done indeed. He does. Get your hair washed. Right, here we go. We've got Alan, he's a butcher. He looks like Jack Nicholson. Got it! Rocking. And finally, you saw him on GMTV with Armin Holmes. It's David Blaine.
It's magic.
It's what?
Magic.
Get up. Well done it. Give him a round of applause for the lookalikes. Who do you look like?
George Clooney.
George Clooney, tell everybody your name.
Warren.
And tell them you lie.
Where's the patient?
Where's the... Thank you. A bit more. Well done indeed. Excellent. They are the lookalikes, and let me explain. The winner of this lookalike competition will go on Gene's books and hopefully make lots and lots of money. We're here today to prove that anybody can be like a lookalike. We've got to have a winner. Which one was the winner?
We've had a chat here amongst us. It's got to be Jack Nicholson.
Jack Nicholson's the winner, everybody! Where's Jack Nicholson? On you come.
Come on, Jack. There he is.
Congratulations. Well done indeed. This is Ian. Ian's going to be taking you on his books. You don't have to be a butcher anymore, because now you're going to be starring in movies. No, don't show me that. He's Jack Nicholson, the winner, everybody! That's it. We're here to prove that everybody can look like somebody. From everybody here at Enfield, it's back to the house.
Yes. Jack Nicholson. Emma, did you enjoy the outside broadcast today?
I did. Fantastic. Jack Nicholson was definitely the best.
Jack was good. Yeah, he was good. Gary Bush, your TV critic. Jack.
Nice.
Squeaky at the Telly Awards, part one.
You know, viewers, ever since I was a small boy, I was always wanted to appear on TV. And when tonight I was told to come here to the Royal Albert Hall for the National Telly Awards, I was very, very excited.
Oh, thank you.
You see, to me, it doesn't matter that I'm not going to win an award or that I haven't been nominated. Because to me, TV isn't about award ceremonies. It's about what the viewers want and what they like. That's all that matters to me. But the viewers will vote for these awards.
Thanks a lot.
How are you? Yeah, not bad.
You're up for a few awards?
Yes, three or four, I think, yeah.
Have you got your speeches lined up?
I
ain't saying nothing, man.
No speeches.
I'm getting
nervous.
A couple of speeches going spare.
Can I tell you one? What is it?
What are you up for?
Best daytime, but we won't win again. We've been going on Countdown 19 years. We've never won a thing.
Have you brought the old guy with you? Charlotte, big night tonight. You're not singing tonight, are you?
No.
Brilliant, thanks. Is that a promise?
It's a promise, yeah.
Excellent. Do you want the false surprise or do you want the cocky one?
Cocky one.
Put it in your pocket. Just read the first bit.
Right, where's the trophy then?
Start off with that, it's always good. Don't say much, you do the talking. What you're seeing now live is Trevor McDonald doing his piece to camera. That's called an idiot board. Not that he is an idiot in any way, shape or form. Someone's playing about with him at the back there. There's no need for that. Somebody's, I don't know what the little guy... Leave him alone! Leave him, he's good! Big night for the Royal Family.
Yeah, great, it's a good night for the Royal Family. Yeah, you know, because one of our relations, young Edward, got us into a lot of trouble in the last few weeks with the camera crew, so it's nice for the other member of the Royal Family to come out and do the business genuinely.
Chris! I want to be a millionaire! Chris! Listen, EastEnders are up there. Are you going to nip it?
I hope so. I mean, who knows? I don't know. Who knows? Hopefully we will, yeah, but who knows? We'll have to wait and see.
You lost me on that. Was that a yes or a no?
That was it. Who knows?
And now Richard Finnegan arrives with his wife, Judy. Judy, you getting him out? Have you got a speech prepared?
Yes.
Okay. You have?
Yes.
I've got a spare one, but I've given two out. But
It's really lovely.
Do you want it?
Yeah.
It's the false surprise one.
Oh, gosh. Are you sure it's for me?
Richard Wilson, how are you, sir?
Very well. I'm going in now.
What are you looking forward to the most tonight?
Having a good time.
You think you'll win?
Oh, no, I doubt it very much.
Me neither. Don't think you've got a cat in hell's chance of winning anything. Not with that attitude, anyway. Chris Tarrant, who wants to be a millionaire?
Yes, how is that little show?
It's doing really well. Do you want to phone a friend to get another vote in?
I'm all right.
Are you sure? Yeah. You've come together. Are you a couple? Graham! You've got her pants on, man!
Graham! You're wearing a trousers! Graham!
Charlotte Church is here tonight. She said that she's not going to sing. Thank you. I know. You singing?
No.
It's 2 out of 2. Thanks a lot. Well, they've all gone in now to enjoy the ceremony. Myself and my pal Jez Edwards from Channel 5's exclusive. We're not allowed in, are we?
No.
So we're just going to hang about here. But join us later. We'll be bringing you all the best bits from tonight's ceremony, plus a reaction from the winners. That's all to come. How's the game of Conkers?
Mine's a tenner.
Mine's bigger than that.
I've heard.
Good.
Squeaky of the Q Awards.
As you know, viewers, 2001 has been a big year for rock and roll music. Big names such as Star Sailor, Muse, and Touring Brooks.
Touring Breaks
are names that just literally roll off my tongue. So when I was told I was coming here to the Park Lane Hotel to cover the Q Awards, I was guaranteed to chat to some big names. Whoever they are. Tune Breaks, hello.
Hello.
You're the first band to be here. Congratulations.
Thank you. We tried our best to get here first. We're good at being early.
Do you want to say anything to your fans?
Good morning. What time is it when this goes out?
Burnage bloke, 11 June bloke. Going to kick it off today?
No.
Truthfully, Liam?
No, I'm not, mate.
No. Because you're from Manchester, you know if you need any help?
Oh, yeah.
The guy behind the camera is quite handy.
Oh, Richard Bacon will be there, won't he?
First question, obviously you've got nice big coats on. Have you heard that they've got heating in here? Or?
Well, we had heard that the central heating had broken down, so we thought we'd come down prepared, but I think they've got it fixed.
That's Cher behind me getting interviewed. Looking well for considering she's nearly a pensioner. She's looking really well. What's happening with Oasis lately?
Nothing.
Why not?
I'm on a bit of a break, doing an album, getting it right, making sure it's proper. And I'll be back here to collect some awards.
Last time I saw you wearing a suit.
I know, Scotland. It was a party in the park, wasn't it?
Yeah, no, tea in the park.
Before you go, any truth in the rumour that you're seeing Patsy Kensit?
No, actually, because I had my glasses on.
Good lad. Any truth in the rumour that you're not seeing Patsy Kensit, are you?
Well, I'm not seeing Patsy Kensit. That's all you'll say.
Any truth in the rumour that you're doing the soundtrack to the James Bond movie?
No.
Truthfully?
No.
You wouldn't tell me if you were, would you?
I don't do like that, man. I'm here to make music, not be on soundtracks.
Are you going out with Patsy Kensit?
Isn't everybody?
But is there any truth in the rumour that you're dating Patsy Kensit?
Who isn't?
Any truth in the rumour that you're currently dating Patsy Kensit?
No, but maybe if I meet her, that we could start dating.
Between me and you, you've probably got a good chance. Okay. I'm actually in the toilets of the Park Lane Hotel. This is Stuart. Hi, Stuart.
Hello.
Yeah, good lad. Now it's time to meet the winners of some of the awards. Are you done? It's okay.
I'll use the towel.
Yeah, use the towel. It's okay. People. It's now time to meet the winners. Last year, Travis won Best Act in the World, and they cemented their success yesterday by winning Best Album for The Invisible Band. This must be the happiest day of your life.
It's pretty cool, actually.
What are you laughing at?
It's just so happy.
You!
The Manic Street Preachers beat fellow Welshman, the Stereophonics, to scoop the award for Best Live Act. Hotly tipped New Kids on the Indie Block, Star Sailor, won Best New Act. Don't you know you've got your daddy's eyes, and daddy was an alcoholic. Have you rang your mum?
I've not rang my mum. I've rang my bird, rang my girlfriend. It's all right.
Well, do you want to ring your mum?
My mum? She'll be at work now.
I'll ring her later for you. And Irish Eyes were definitely smiling on Ash as they won Best Single for Burn, Baby Burn. Well, viewers, that's it for another year. 12 awards in 45 minutes. Not bad going. Bit disappointed, however, that Jay McDonald live in Las Vegas didn't win anything. Still, there's always next year. But for now, this is Mike McLean in the middle of the road for the Q Awards 2001. Nice bike. Cheers, big man.
Squeaky of the Q Awards. Thank you.